Ready, Jitansh? 5, 6, 7. Good morning, students. Let's understand the idea of cyclotron, a device which was invented in 1934 by Mr. Livingston and Lawrence. Well, this entire device, which was invented with one particular idea to get high accelerated particles of proton as well as deuteron and many other heavy alpha particles. Now, why, if you ask me, these high accelerated particles were used, I would say a bombarding experiment for scattering experiment, which you will come across very soon. So let's understand the basic principle and working of cyclotron. You can achieve high velocity of particle by making them move in circular motion like a slingshot at a very high speed, and then at a particular point throw it out. So let's understand the construction and working of cyclotron. Well, cyclotron consists of two hollow semicircular disc called Ds, where the flat portion is separated by a certain distance and they are parallel to each other. Well, these two Ds are connected to an alternating power supply called an oscillator, because this oscillator gives them polarities which are opposite, and the polarity switches after regular interval of time. So if one becomes positive, another becomes negative, you will find there is an electric field between the gap. This electric field starts from D1, it goes to D2. Now, after a certain interval of time, the polarity switches from negative to positive and so on. And so does the direction of electric field also changes. Now, to get a magnetic field, we introduce an electromagnet down and above. And these lines of magnetic field goes from South Pole to North Pole, that is from down to up. So if you observe carefully, the electric field is horizontal and the magnetic field is vertical. They both are perpendicular to each other. So this basic setup is enclosed inside the vacuum chamber, and this is how the experimental setup is. Point to be noted, dear students, that there are two fields acting. One is electric, that is horizontal, and another is magnetic field, that is vertical. So let's understand the working of what exactly happens. We introduce a positive ion between these two Ds. It can be proton, it can be proton and neutron, deuteron, alpha particles, so on. Now, due to the positive and negative charges and due to the presence of electric field, this positively charged ion, it gets attracted in negative plate with certain force, which is given by QE. Now, if the force is exerted on this positive particle, it gets accelerated with QE by M. And with that acceleration, the velocity increases and it goes towards the negative plate. But as soon as it enters the negative plate, there is no longer acceleration. Why? Because there is no longer electric field inside that hollow circular part. So here, when the particle enters into the blue disk, the velocity becomes constant. And the moment it enters, it is subjected to the magnetic field. And we have learned in our previous class that whenever a charged particle moves inside a magnetic field, it traces a circular path. In our case, it is a semicircular path, but the velocity remains constant. There is no acceleration. Please note my point. Magnetic field does not accelerate. It simply traces a path, which is semicircular in this case. Well, the moment it enters out, it goes in another disk, then it comes back to this disk, and the radius keeps on increasing, which is given by MV by QB, which you will know very soon. But now let's understand what happens when it tries to come out. The time taken for this semicircular motion is T by 2. If you ask why, the entire time taken to go in both the Ds is T. So in half the Ds is what? T by 2. Okay. This time remains constant, but the particle, when it tries to come out, the polarity changes. So now the opposite plate becomes negatively charged compared to this plate. So what happens is this particle now gets attracted. Earlier it had a velocity V. It traced a semicircular path. Now when it comes out, the polarity changes. It gets accelerated towards this newly circular D. So when it gets accelerated, the velocity increases but the velocity only increases between the gap. Once it enters D2, the velocity again remains constant, that is V1. Please make a note, V1 is more than V. So again, when it comes out, the polarity changes. Again, it gets accelerated. And now this particle enters back to D1 with new velocity. And if you want, you can call that velocity as V2. So please understand, my dear students, the acceleration of the particle only and only takes place between the two D's and not inside the D. This is the most important point which you try to miss. So let the velocity now be V2. Now V2 is more than V1. Again, it is subjected to the magnetic field. It follows a semicircular path and again it comes out. And each time it comes out, the velocity keeps on increasing. That means the particle is now getting accelerated. That's the whole idea, right? So let it again go inside the plate D2. So the moment it enters into D2, we have another velocity V3, which is more than V2, which was more than V1, and it keeps on increasing. It follows a circular path with increasing radius. Yes, my dear students, velocity increases. At the same time, the radius also increases. But the time period of the particle inside the D remains constant, which is in sync with the time period of the oscillator. This is the basic functioning of a cyclotron, which looks somewhat like this. So now, my dear students, let's understand the detailed concept of today's lecture, that is cyclotron. Well, cyclotron is a device used to accelerate positively charged particle. So let me just stop here. Why not negative particles? We have example on the screen like protons, deuterons, alpha. It was invented in 1932, 34 by Lorentz and, you know, Livingston. But why not negative? Food for the thought. I'll come back to that point soon. This was a device as big as the entire room. So when you write an answer, okay, a theoretical answer, this is how you write. First is the principle. Now, whatever animation we saw step by step, that's what our entire principle is. First of all, it's all about positive charge particle. It has to be accelerated. And why accelerate? So that we can get high energies. If you must have seen Iron Man 2, in that he keeps on circulating the charge particle and finally bombards it on a metal. And that metal changes its composition, giving you a new metal, which you will learn very soon in forthcoming chapters. And this is done with a small alternating field, that is oscillator, making them to cross the electric field again and again by making use of strong magnetic field. That's the principle. So please try to understand. The key words are positive particle, acceleration for high energy, alternating field by oscillator, electric field for acceleration, magnetic field for direction. That's it. And voila, your principle is ready. Now, the first cyclotron was almost as big as your entire home. Okay. So now the second point, which my dear students, you have to write inside an exam, is the construction. You now by this, you must have already mastered all these points. So what construction actually includes? Step number one, 2Ds. Okay. They are semicircular, they are hollow, and they're separated by a certain distance, a gap in which the ion is introduced. Right. And these 2Ds are then connected to an alternating source so that the polarity can change after regular interval of time, and that time is constant. It does not change. Such a simple idea, right? Now, this is how we get electric field. But to get magnetic field, we place two electromagnets down and above. So the magnetic field is what? Perpendicular to the planes. Okay. And electric field is used to accelerate the charge, and the magnetic field is used to produce a circular motion. That's a basic principle, I guess. So let's answer a beautiful riddle. Cyclotron is a device by which a high frequency wave can be generated. Did we ever speak about wave? No. Positively charged ions can be accelerated to a high energy. Yes. Electrons can be accelerated. We didn't come across electron, but electron is a negatively charged particle. And yes, as per the principle, it can, but we can't. Why? Yes, anyone can answer that? not because of that. Electrons cannot be used because electrons are 1,000 times lighter in mass compared to protons or neutrons. Now, if you ask me, so what? The lesser the mass, okay, the more chances they can go into relativistic quantum physics. For example, you will study in this de Broglie hypothesis that a particle with very less mass exhibits the matter waves. So at a very high speed, that is relativistic speed, maybe this entire mass starts getting into wave and you won't get a particle, but you will get a wave. And to be very simple, that light particle electron is not at all sufficient to bombard anything. So for you right now, instead of relativistic idea and all that, electron is much more lighter to bring about any experimentation. So we cannot use electron. Sorry. Neutron cannot be accelerated. It's neutral charge. So the answer, it has to be B. Well, that's what we studied in our principle, right? Now, cyclotron is used to accelerate A protons, yes. B electrons, absurd, no. C alpha particle, yes. So the answer is both A and C. How simple it becomes, you see? Well, proceeding ahead, a cyclotron electric field is used to do what? Now, before even the question ends, you already have an answer. Electric field always accelerates. So let's see. Accelerated charge particle, yes. Deaccelerated, no. It can, but we are not using that principle here. To produce circular motion, voila, no. Circular motion is done by only one field, that is called magnetic field. If you must have read my previous class, a particle entering inside a magnetic field always traces a circular path. Okay? The force is tangential at every point, if you remember. So the answer is what? Beautiful. A. So students, let's understand the working, which we have already understood such beautifully. A source produces an ion, that is positively charged particle between two plates. Now, due to the alternating potential difference, one becomes positive, another becomes negative rapidly in a given interval of time. So when one is positive, another is negative, the particle is repelled by D1, attracted by D2. Now, magnetic field, which is perpendicular to the direction of the motion, it causes the particle to move along circular path in the D2. There's no electric field inside that circular disk. Please remember that as one of the MCQ question. So the polarity of B is reversed. The particle again enters into the previous part. The polarity again gets reversed and keeps on entering into the D's in alternating time period of time. Along with the acceleration, because the velocity keeps on increasing. So every time the particle enters the gap, when the polarity of the D is reversed, inside D1, the particle again moves along a semicircular path. So when they emerge out of the cyclotron window, the speed is so large that it can actually break a particular structure of an element or an atom. That is the whole purpose of using cyclotron. So magnetic field accelerates a positive charge particle. Sorry, it's false. Okay. Coming towards the next part, in cyclotron, the charged particles are accelerated by, there's only one field, that is electric field. So let's understand the option. Electrostatic deflector plate. Now, where did electrostatic came into place? No. Electric field in the D's can be. Magnetic field inside the D. Let's not be absurd. It just changes the direction. Potential difference across the gap. Yes. So the answer is B as well as D. Can anyone tell me which can be the right one? My dear, B cannot be the right one. If you read carefully, it is electric field in the D's. It was clearly mentioned. There is no electric field inside the D. So the answer is potential difference between the gaps of the D. Okay. Now, see, dear students, after understanding a theory, there are many points which are derived. We already have talked so much about radius, it keeps on increasing. So much about velocity keeps on increasing. The time period, the energy. So now the only duty is to bring all these expressions into formula. For that, you must have a theme, a title, an opening statement. So for us, the opening statement is that the magnetic field exerted by the positively charged provides the necessary centripetal force. Exactly. सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड क्या करता है, सर्कुलर मोशन में लेकर आता है, जब सर्कुलर मोशन में आएगा तभी कौन सा फोर्स एग्जर्ट होता है, इनवर्ड वाला, सेंट्रीपिटल. सो व्हाट इज मैग्नेटिक फोर्स का फॉर्मूला, क्यू ई बी साइन थीटा, बट हियर इट इज परपेंडिकुलर सो थीटा इज 90. सो क्यू ई बी इज इक्वल टू सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स दैट इज एम वी स्क्वायर बाय आर. नाउ क्विकली टेक योर पेन एंड पेंसिल एंड गिव मी द फॉर्मूला ऑफ आर. सो आफ्टर वन मिनट, ब्यूटिफुल, आर इज इक्वल टू एम बी बाय क्यू बी. एम इज मास, B is yield, Q is charge, these three are constant. So ladies and gentlemen, I give to you the relation. As velocity keeps on increasing, the radius keeps on increasing. So that's why from small circle to big circle. And finally, like a slingshot, it just went out. Okay? This is radius, MV by QB, MV by QB. So now from radius, you can bring so many formula, time period. Now, before even starting the derivation, we'll complete the derivation. What is time? Speed is distance upon time. Time is what? Distance by speed. Here, what is the distance? And what is the speed? So let's start. Here, the time period is what? 2 pi by omega. Correct? So the actual time inside 1V is the half of it, that is pi by omega. Omega, you already know, is V by R. So what is time is equal to pi R by V. Right? So if you understand the idea to put the formula of R from previous derivation, R is what? MV by QB. So I guess VB get cancelled. And my dear students, time becomes pi M by QB. Pi is constant. M is constant. B is constant. Q is constant. Voila. Time period is constant. See? Such a beautiful chapter. Full of concepts. Understanding the time period required by the ions is independent of radius. आप कितना भी velocity बढ़ाओ, time वही का वही रहेगा, उतने ही time तक रहेगा. इसमें it is clear the ions arrive at each time at a certain gap and exceed exactly the same as the alternating potential which accelerates it. So it can be given by finally the total time period is what? 2t. That is 2 pi m by q. That's the next formula. And what is the frequency? The fourth formula, 1 by time. Simple. 2b by 2 pi m. The condition of equal frequency is called resonance condition. Hence, the frequency is called magnetic resonance frequency. Why? Jis frequency ke saath tumhara particle move ho raha aur jo alternating supply, that is the applied frequency jo hai, aapki same ho jati hai. So, this condition is called magnetic resonance frequency. Kinetic energy, I won't do it. You only start. What is the formula? Half mv square. Put the formula of V. Get me the answer. So after 1 minute, you can use this part also. Evaluate by magnetic force is same as centripetal force. So kinetic energy is nothing but what? Perfect. So when asked in a derivation, please apply this. Don't apply the formula if V is already given by this. You won't get marks. So kinetic energy is Q square B square R square by 2m. Is it easy? Are you all understanding? Clear? So here is, we have a small numerical. A cyclotron has a frequency of 12 megahertz. So frequency, time, chalo, malum padega. And D is of radius 5. So we have R. Thank God. Calculate the magnetic induction B to accelerate deuterons. Aapko B pucha hai. Aur deuteron ka mass ki hai, M ki hai. Charge diya hai Q. And calculate the energy acquired. मतलब आपको B ढूंढना और energy ढूंढना है. तो ये सारी चीजें दिए हुई है और आपको B और E ढूंढना है. So सबसे पहले formula. आपको पता है QVB is equal to MV square by R. तो B is MV by R cube. Current and E energy is nothing but this, right? ये दो formula हमारे पास है. Value put up करके log anti log use करना शुरू कर दो बेटा. Fine. So after using the entire log calculation step by step, okay, this is where we come to. I'll just skip through this entire part. Energy mil gaya. Now the energy, if you find it is in joule, but we want electron volt for smaller particle. So let's understand, 1 mega electron volt, 1 MeV is 1.10 to minus 13 joule. अब बोलेंगे सर माइनस 19 था ना, बेटा वो वन इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट था, ये मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, वी वांट द आंसर इन एमईवी. सो एनर्जी अपने को जो जूल में मिला था, आप बस इसको डिवाइड कर दो, वापस लॉग एंटी लॉग यूज करो ना, आपको मिल जाएगा एनर्जी इन एमईवी. Now, radius of the particle is inversely proportional to velocity. Is true or false? Absurd. It's false. It's directly proportional. Time period of cyclotron is independent of mass, charge, magnetic field, velocity. What is the formula of time? Exactly. It depends on all these things except for the velocity. Right? I m by qb. So it depends on mass, it depends on field, it depends on charge. Frequency is given by, just now you found out, what is it? 1 by t, yes. Qb by 2 pi m, yes. 2 pi m by qb, no, that is for time period. So the answer is both A and B. Good. Now, har cheez ka bhi apna ek limitations hota hai, so cyclotron ka bhi apna ek limitation. First, not accelerate uncharged particles like neutron. Neutron is also very good. It's also heavy just like proton, but it cannot be used, sadly. It cannot accelerate electrons since they are very small. And because they are very small, very light, they cannot bring that bombardment. And relativistic thing is another issue. Positive charged particle having large mass, ions cannot move at limitless speed in electron. Because zyada hi mass bhi achha bhi nahi. Use kaha hota hai? The heavy particles like alpha, helium can be accelerated. So accelerated in the case they use hota hai. It provides a continuous stream of ions. And aapko maine Iron Man ka example already diya tha ki acceleration kyun chahiye. And the size of accelerator is comparatively small. Ye uska advantage. So cyclotron accelerates the particle m, the charge q, kinetic energy is proportional to what? Just apply the basic formula mv square by r is equal to qev, and you will get your answer. What's the answer? Perfect. Q square by m. Right? Cyclotron cannot accelerate particles like, answer is what? Neutron, yes. Alpha, deuteron, proton, yes, they can. Neutron, they cannot. My dear students, sometimes you don't have to remember so much of formula. Just the starting hint, and it will do. Assertion and reason. Very interesting one. Assertion is cyclotron cannot accelerate electrons. True. Reason is mass of electron is very small. That is also true. So first, both A and R are correct. Yes. And R explains A. Yes. Second option says both A and R are correct, but R does not explain it. R definitely explains it. So B cannot be the answer. A is true, R is false. This is false, that is true. Observe. So the answer is what? A. My dear students, here we understand and complete the idea of cyclotron, which was used earlier, invented in 1934. And there are certain uses which we'll be seeing very soon. I hope you all enjoyed. This is the homework for today. Thank you very much. See you all very soon.